Next, we will see how to create NuGet packages. If we are working in any of the project, we might need to add some DLL which are created by the Microsoft or any third party vendor. Or we also can share our own DLL which our team members can use it. So how to do that? Let's just see by jumping into the code. I have created one small project of class library in .NET Core and which I have just checked in into the Azure DevOps. So what I am going to do, I'll create the DLL of this particular class library and then we will see how we can use that. So the name of the project is NuGet CI/CD and let me just show it to you in the Azure DevOps. So this is the project in the Azure DevOps which I've created and where I have added the class library. If I click on the repo, so this is the project which I checked in. And before going into or creating a CI/CD for the NuGet, let me just show you the place where we will be storing the NuGet packages. So under the artifacts, there is a something called as a feed, artifact feed, where we will store, manage the NuGet packages which we are going to create. So to do that, first what I have to do, I have to create a new feed and let me just name it as a NuGet CI/CD feed. And visibility, I'll keep it same, and upstream source also and scope also. So there is no change. I'll click on create. Once this is done, a feed is created. So under this location, whatever the DLL which I am going to create using this project, it will come and store. So next, under the pipeline, click on create pipeline and I'll use the classic editor and no change here. Source is same, project and repo is also same. So I'll click on continue and here I'll select the ASP.NET Core template since the class library project is a .NET Core. I'll click apply. Now, one important thing. So all the tasks, I'll not go and change anything, but one thing which I want to change here for the NuGet, we should have the latest version. So currently 5.9.1 is the latest one. So I'll use that to install that. So what I'm going to do, I just added the number 5.9.1, the version number. Next, we have to add two tasks. So I'll click on the plus icon and I'll search for NuGet. And this is the one which I want to add. Click on add. And instead of restore, we should have the pack command and there is no other change. And one more task which I want to add, and that is also of NuGet, the same one, and it will be push. And the target feed, it want us to select. So we have just created that NuGet CI/CD feed. This is the one. So we are good with this. These two tasks which we have created, the first one, NuGet pack, is required to create the NuGet packages, the DLL, and the next one, it will push into the target location, so which is a feed which we have just created. Once this is done, click on save and queue and agent specification just changes to Windows 2019. Click save and run. And if you want to see the logs, click on the agent job one. So the build has completed. Now let me just go to artifacts and see, and I'll select the NuGet CI/CD. Bingo, we are good. So this is a place and where the NuGet is created. Once the NuGet DLL is created, we have to add it. To do that, let's just see in the next video. To add the DLL, click on the package which you have created and then click on the connect to feed, then click on NuGet.exe. So in this particular place, it has mentioned the steps which you can perform to add the DLL, or what you can do, just click on this particular URL, just copy that and move to the any of the project, the solution where you want to add that. So let's assume you want to add the DLL in this particular project which you have just created. But first what we have to do, we have to add the NuGet location. So go to tools, click on options, search for the NuGet. Click on general, click on package sources. Now here we have to add the NuGet package source which we have just created. Then click on the plus icon. And in the source, just enter the URL which you have just copied. And you can give any of the name. So let's just say NuGet CI/CD. Click OK. Now, if you want to add the DLL, go to dependencies, right click, click click on manage NuGet packages. Click on browse. And if you want, you can change the source here. I'll select the source NuGet CI/CD. And it will show the DLL which we have just created. So this is how we can add the DLL which we have just created. To add, you just need to click on install, and if this DLL is compatible with your project, it will automatically get installed in your solution, and then you can use that. Next, we will see how to create the versioning. I am in the CI pipeline, and under the NuGet pack task, click on the pack options. By default, the automatic package versioning is off. If you want, you can enable it. And there are three ways which the Azure DevOps has provided. You can use the date time, you can use the environment variable, or you can use the build number. So I'll click on the date time, and it will always give us, so the version as it 100, and then the UTC timings with that. So let me just save it and save in queue, and I'll use the Windows 2019, and I'll click save and then, and then we will see how the version it will create. Once the build is completed, click on artifacts, click on NuGet CI/CD, click on versions. Now, here you can see the new DLL which we have just added, and it has also attached the UTC timing. Now, this is one of the way how you can create the versions, and since there are other options also, you can just play around with them and see how the versioning is done. So we just saw how to create a NuGet, how to add it into any of the project, how to create the versioning of the NuGet. But last thing which I want to mention, the best place to create the NuGet is in the continuous deployment. It is not CI. The reason being, whenever any developer is working, he will be doing the check-in multiple times, and we don't want the multiple version of the same code. So it's better we should add the two tasks which we have created, NuGet pack and NuGet push, in the continuous deployment, so that when we are sure, or whenever we are sending the product to the release, only that time the DLL is created, not before that. But I leave this decision entirely up to you. You can add it into CI also, but CD also. But as per me, the best place is in the CD. Thank you.